Now, yeah. So, the main important thing that we want to do when we have a problem that looks like this is we basically when we're asked to identify the degree and the leading coefficient. So the main important thing that we want to do is rewrite this so every term is in what we call descending powers. Okay? So we look at our powers, and we have a 3 and a 2, but there's no other powers. So I think it's helpful for you guys to understand, where are the rest of the powers? Well, we can always write x to the x as x to the first power. And if we don't have an x, we could always rewrite it as x to the 0. I'm just doing this as a teaching practice for you guys to understand that you have 3, 2, 1, and 0. You can always do that for all polynomials. You can always just continually. So you want to go in descending order with the largest power first. So the exponent with the largest power is 1 half x cubed. So I write that first. 1 half x cubed minus 3x squared plus 8x to the first minus 2. I don't write the x to the 0 or the first power because I don't have to. When we write polynomials, we don't do that. All right, we don't have to do that. I'm just using it as a visual aid for you guys to understand that those powers are there. Now, all we're basically doing is identifying the leading coefficient and the degree. The degree is your largest power, which in this case is 3. Your leading coefficient is the coefficient of that exponent of your leading term, which in this case is 1 half. That was it. Fine. Leading coefficient.